Yeah, students, how are you? I believe you are doing really good. Okay, I would like us to proceed from where we stopped, from our topic, petty cash book. And don't forget what petty means. It means small. You get it? So now let's go straight to the illustration we have. Record the following in the relevant columns of the petty cash book of Chillington a sole proprietor. So I believe you know what a sole proprietor means. All right, now January 1, petty cashier received an impressed amount of 2,000 naira. Now let's see the effect of what happened in January 1. Don't forget, they received, so they actually received at the first day of January, which you have on your debit column of the petty cash book as amount received here. Did you take note of that? So that amount received, which is 2,000 naira, will be recorded under that column, which is what? January 1, which is the date. You take note of that? Okay, so you leave that for that. Now let's proceed. January 2, paid for bus fare 200 naira. Paid for bus fare 200 naira. January 2. This is January 2. You have it here. You have bus fare under your particular. And that is the first voucher for that month, because it is an expenses. And every expenses has to be on the debit side. Is that clear? Okay, so paid for transport fare. So that will be under your transport of 200 naira. And that's the only transaction that took place that day, bus fare. So your total for that day will be 200 naira as well. Do you understand that? All right, so they are simple. January 4, paid for postage 150 naira. You have a January 4 here, and you have the particular to be postage. That is your second voucher for the month of January. So your postage will be recorded under postage column, which is 150 naira. And since there was no other transaction that took place that day, so you have your total of 150 naira under your total amount column. I believe you're following me. Okay. Now January 8, paid for duplicating paper 300 naira. So anything that has to do with paper will fall under your stationery. So you have January 8 paper, which is your third voucher, 300 naira for that day. And that's the only transaction that took place for that day. So your total amount for the transaction that took place that day will be 300 naira. You understand that number? Okay, we can. January 12, bought envelope for 250 naira. So you bought envelope for 250 naira, that will fall under your postage as well. January 12, envelope. That's your fourth voucher for the month, which will fall under your postage, like I said, 250 naira, and you have as the total here. Please ignore this 500 naira. I will tell you why I asked you to ignore it. Let's proceed. January 16, paid Mr. Kalu 500 naira. So now the sum of 500 naira is being paid to Kalu, which is on January 16. Mr. Kalu, 500 naira. So this 500 naira I asked you to ignore previously should be in this column. It's a typographical error. You understand what I'm trying to communicate? So this 500 naira should be in this column. Sorry for that. So that is the total transaction for that day, and you have your total amount to be what? 500 naira. So this should be year, not year. You understand that now? So let's proceed. January 25, bought office pin 100 naira. Bought office pin. This is January 25. That's an office. It falls under your office. You get it now? So which is what? 100 naira. And the total expense for that day as well is 100 naira. I believe you are getting it gradually. It's so simple. You could see simple. January 26, both stamps, 100 naira. Both stamps, 100 naira. So this is January 26, your stamp under your particular, which shows it is your 7th voucher for the month of January. Your stamp as well falls under what? Postage too. Your stamp, your envelope, and your books or paper, they fall under your postage. So you have 100 naira and the total as well to be 100 naira. I hope you're following me. Now, January 30, paid taxi fare. Taxi fare, automatically you know where that will also go to. This falls under transport. Get it? Taxi fare, 200 naira. So January 30, this is the date. You understand? You have your taxi fare, which is the 18th voucher for the month of January, which falls under your transport. You can see it's here. It's here. So you have your transport, and the total should be as well 200 naira. Okay. Now, you now have to sum up all what you have here, and all what you have here, and all what you have here, all what you have in this column. Everything, you sum them up down to this place. All what you have here is 300 naira. All what you have here is 400 naira. All what you have here is 100. All what you have here is 500. But here, there's a little mistake here. Now, let me show you. 150 plus this gives us what? 400 naira. 400 naira plus 100 gives us what? 500 naira. So there's a typographical error. You should be having 500 naira here, not 300 naira. So this should be 500 naira. You get that? So 300 plus 500 gives you what? 800. 800 plus 400 gives you 1200 plus 100, 1300, isn't it? Plus 500, that's 1800. So the sum, the addition of all this, excluding this 300, gives us what? 1800. So, and that's what you have here. You get that now? So now this 1000 is our total expenses for the month of January. Now you have to deduct this 1800 from the impress amount you have here that you received here, which is 2000 naira. So 2000 naira minus 1800 that we have gives you what? A balance carry down, which will be on the 31st of 200 naira. So a balance, you have 200 naira left, and when you place the 200 naira here, in addition to 1800, it gives you your 2000 naira. You understand? So now that 200 naira that you have left, that's the amount we didn't spend for the month of January. We spent 1800 naira on expenses. We have 200 naira left, so it is that amount that will be brought to another month, which is the month of February. You can see February 1, we have 200 naira here, which is the balance carried down, or rather it should be balance brought forward. So that's as simple as petty cash book is. So watch the video as many times as you could, watch it as often as you could, and get the explanation right, so you have an evaluation to do for the week. Do enjoy yourself and stay blessed. Bye bye.